And now it's time to reanimate this week's biggest bogon emitter. And in case you were wondering how This American Life avoided it, check out what USA Today did when they were trying to school people on guns, specifically the one used at the Texas church shooting, what they call an AR-15 style rifle. In fairness, they did go on to identify it as a Ruger AR-556, like we mentioned last week, and just to close the loop on several comments we got in response to that, the AR-15 is made by Colt. AR-15s can only be made by Colt, in fact, because it's a trademark of Colt's manufacturing. Another gun company could make an identical weapon, they just couldn't call it an AR-15. Anyway, we did point out significant differences between the AR-15 and the AR-556, including caliber and muzzle velocity. Anyway, they went on to list a bunch of aftermarket options, which went to ridiculous levels, culminating in the one that made it an internet meme, the chainsaw bayonet. You know, now that I think about it, Chainsaw Bayonet would be a great name for a hardcore punk band. They had to follow it up with, quote, "To clarify, the video shows both the shooter's modifications as well as other possible modifications. The shooter did not use a chainsaw bayonet." So, of course, it got memed left, right, and center. Well, not so much left, but people were taking pictures of pizza cutters and other weird things they had attached to a rifle barrel, and others were doing graphics where they added things like a lightsaber, Harry Potter's wand, the Doctor's sonic screwdriver, Audrey 2, a piranha plant from Super Mario Brothers, a velociraptor, that toaster pastry bit into the shape of a gun, and, of course, the Illudium Q36 explosive space modulator, although they misspelled it. One even had an infinite regression of chainsaws attached to rifles attached to chainsaws. So yes, this was yet another example of leftist news media not knowing anything about guns in a case where they actually tried and still failed miserably. So cartoonist Eric Alley gleefully twisted the knife with a cartoon depicting an elephant and a donkey in front of a diagram of a mislabeled AR-15, and the elephant says, "You can't write laws about stuff you know nothing about." And the donkey says, "Why not? We did it with healthcare." So all of that makes USA Today this week's biggest bogon emitter.